Okay, you get ready.
But you have to push it.
I'll push it. Oh, good one! Here we go.
What a difference one season has made in the lives of Gabby Gingras and her family.
Catch the ball.
Woo! Boy, it's so nice to get to spring.
So much has changed.
Now we may have a chance to really help her.
I worked at that dog.
It was winter when we first introduced you to Gabby.
Is that fun?
Yeah.
One more time?
No.
A 3-year-old from Big Lake who has never felt pain.
Okay, should go in and have some supper?
No matter how hard Gabby falls, no matter how often she hits her head, no tears.
Watch your head, sweet pea.
The result of a genetic disorder that gave Gabby no functioning pain nerves.
Ah, honey, you can't do that. You'll hurt your head.
You can't do that, Gabby.
You'll hurt your head.
Not the pain-free life some might consider a blessing, but a curse that's left Gabby blistered from burns she never felt, with teeth she broke off as quick as she got them.
Look up, Charlie's up here.
And with a left eye, swollen and blind from glaucoma. Because Gabby felt no pain, she damaged her eyes with her own fingers before her parents started putting her in swim goggles round the clock. Gabby's condition is so rare that when we first told you about her in February, neither her parents nor her doctors knew of another patient like Gabby in the country.
That's the one thing we would just love to have. Is another family, someone who knows what we've gone through.
Trish Gingras didn't know it at the time, but her appeal for support would be heard around the world.
Yes, there are no support groups.
Gabby's story has been viewed more than any other extra ever posted on care11.com.
Honey, you can't do that.
She never cried.
Oh, Gabby will occasionally slip and fall.
Paul Harvey picked it up for his national radio show.
We need pain.
I'm doing it.
To help remind us what not to do.
A British tabloid was among the newspapers writing articles, and scores of supportive emails and letters poured in.
I'm sure she captures hearts wherever she goes. God bless and take care.
Among them, an email from a family in Norway whose 7-year-old daughter has the same condition as Gabby.
I'm writing to let you know that Gabby is not the only one with type 5.
But this email arrived from an address even closer to home.
This is Sarah. She's 7 years old.
In 1988, unbeknownst to the Gingrasses, a girl named Sara Roberts was featured in a PBS documentary called The Mind. 4 years earlier, the Mayo Clinic had diagnosed Sarah as the first recorded case of hereditary sensory and autonomic neuropathy type 5, the same condition as Gabby.
Okay, that's high enough there now. Hey, where are you going now?
Because she has no pain, she's not afraid of anything.
Sarah is 24 now. We met her at her home in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, 4 hours away from the Gingrasses.
There's you when you were a little bitty baby.
Sarah's story starts much like Gabby's.
Here you are without teeth.
Lost teeth and chewed fingers.
There's your first brace.
Broken bones and burns.
It was Christmas Eve. We were at family. And there was candle on the table, and she's standing by the table, just going like this.
The different ones you click on.
That Christmas Eve cost Sarah part of her finger. Yes. But the condition she shares with Gabby also cost Sarah her legs.
Hey, let's dance!
Time after time, Sarah had injured her knees. Pain wasn't there to tell her when to stop putting weight on a break, a sprain, or a swollen joint. Her parents tried to keep her safe.
We didn't succeed.
But over time, the damage was too great, and Sarah's legs had to be amputated.
There you are.
She's happy. She handles it better than we do. Mm-hmm. She kind of is, this is where I am, and this is fine.
Judy and Bill Roberts don't know if their daughter's developmental problems are related to the pain disorder.
Rex!
They do know Sarah has done well with what she has, volunteering at a hospital, graduating from high school, and now making a difference for a little girl from Minnesota.
Hey, funny.
Two families of daughters that had never met another person with the same condition.
Uncle Carl. It's my Game Boy SP.
Sit down at a Twin Cities restaurant to begin what they hope is a lasting relationship.
It's another friendship, but it's a friendship with purpose.
Yeah. You like Barney?
Yeah.
So but most of the time I like you.
Trish and Steve Gingras are already learning information about Sara.
You know, jumped up and landed on her knees.
They hope will help them protect Gabby.
Bye, Gabby.
Information they also hope will help them start a website that could connect them with still unknown families searching for their own answers.
We feel so much better just to know there's other people out there.
Don't get seasick.
Which is why spring truly is a time of new beginnings for the Gingras family.
Spring has come. We can get our breath again and move on. And
careful.
Even a support group as exclusive as theirs is better than being alone.
Woo! Talkie.
Boyd Hooper, Care 11 News, Big Lake.
Careful, don't twirl into each other.